Snyder, Buzz, back of the net, fighting for control of the puck with 29 seconds to play. Baker! Go, Baker! With 27 seconds remaining in the game, and look at that scene on the ice. The Americans tie the Swedes. Baker from out in front, beating Lindbergh to tie it 2-2.
The American passing very sharply. We're able to come back to tie the game at 4:39 mark of the first period on that goal by Mike Arruzioni, number 21, the team captain, the assist by Neil Broughton, number 9.
Broughton gets the puck over to Arruzioni, but it's in his skates, and he has to kick it ahead, giving him a very bad angle to shoot at. Here's the pass from Broughton over to Arruzioni, who kicks it ahead at a bad angle, but Kralik stays well into his net, giving the corner for...
That tied the game 1-1, then a minute six later, the U.S. scoring to make it 2-1 on that goal by number 16, Mark Pavlich from Buzz Schneider and John Harrington.
Mark Pavlich found Schneider with a good pass, putting Schneider into the open for a backhand. Kralik couldn't handle the shot, let out the rebound. Here's Schneider breaking in on the backhand. Kralik tries to catch it, but instead knocks it out in front of the net. Pavlich can't get much of it.
Players. Pavlich, who set up the goal by Baker the other night with a great pass. Pavlich, number 16, tries to backhand it out in front of the net. Puts it in. Buzz Schneider, number 25. He is the only man on this team who played on the 76 Olympic team. That's how young this team is. The average 22 years old. Schneider, one of the old men at 25, and it's 3-2 U.S.
Here's Mark Pavlich with a puck. He dumps it in front of the net to Buzz Schneider. Just tips the backhand into the corner. There's a line that is essentially being used as a defensive line to go against the top Czechoslovakia line of Averman, Novak, and Martinets. And they've been threatening all night, with Pavlich scoring in the first period and Schneider here in the second. Here's the replay against Schneider, finding himself alone in front, just tipping it into the corner. Time with this U.S. team. U.S. team wants to apply the pressure.
That's it! He scores! He backhands it by Kralik to make it 4-2. And as Ken just said, the U.S. wants to apply the pressure, and Johnson responds at the 15:28 mark of the second period.
The U.S. team fought the Czechs in a change. The only Czechoslovakia player back. Lost the puck along the boards. And out in front to Mark Johnson. With the play along the boards, Johnson comes out all by himself. Is coming out. Kralik is perhaps bothered a little bit by couldn't back off any farther.
This is Preston, tries to split the defense. Pass save, and the rebound goes in. Goal, he scores! McClanahan able to put it in as he was going
Penalty coming 25 seconds into the second period. Andersen in the penalty box for Norway. Davy Christian, his shot is saved and then deflected in by Aruzioni. Aruzioni got the rebound. Number 21, the team captain. And so the United States just 16 seconds into a power play opportunity and 41 seconds into the second period. Ties Norway 1-1.
Just what you're looking for when you're having a bit of a struggling time is to get the power play opportunity. It's a great equalizer, and the U.S. team equalized with it. Here's the pass out to Dave Christian, who works in and forces Martinsen into a difficult save. And with that save, he made the rebound and was defenseless with a shot.
So the United States won and Norway. While we were away, Mark Johnson has just scored for the United States. The U.S. takes a 2-1 lead at the 4:51 mark. Johnson from out in front. We'll see it again.
Rob McClanahan has the puck in the corner. He sees Mark Johnson in front of the net. Mark lets it go immediately just inside the post. An excellent shot. Here's McClanahan out in front of the net. And it's by Martinsen. 23-24.
Well, whatever Herb Brooks said, as you look at Johnson, remember Johnson was questionable. He had that bruised shoulder after taking the check the other night late in the game. Taken away, but there is Pavlich who gets it back to Silk, who scores! Davy Silk from Mark Pavlich.
Play that seemed to be pretty well in control as far as the Norwegians were concerned in their end. Control as Mark Pavlich found Dave Silk in front of the net for the 3-1 lead.
Dave Silk scored the first goal in the Sweden game the other night. 6:29 to go in the period.
Once again, it's Mark
to save. Loose puck out in front. The rebound goes in by Wells. Mark Wells, number 15, to make it 4-1.
Taking advantage of some rather poor clearing by the Norwegians. Got the rebound. Here we see the original shot. It's a high shot, high on Martinsen. Really too high to control. The rebound comes out, and it appears as if Norway has enough time to clear the puck. They skate right by it, leaving it there for Wells, who just flips it in.
So Mark Wells scoring, 15:26 to play in the period. 4-1 American. Strobel to McClanahan. Rob, number 24, centers it out in front, but Strobel can't get his stick down. Out it comes to Morrow. Slap shot goes in. Kenny Morrow took it off the board, and the United States leads it 5-1.
That's the kind of goal that all goalies have nightmares about. The shot by Ken Morrow from the point, it was going slowly enough that you as a goalie are almost sure that it's going to be deflected. So you don't make a move for it, and you find the puck going undeflected. Here's the shot by Morrow. It's unobstructed and undeflected. But Martinsen was lulled into allowing it to go by him.
In yellow and the United States in blue. As we take a look at the first goal scored by the USA at 12:03 of the first period, a picture-perfect goal scored by number 25, Buzz Schneider.
Once again, it's the Pavlich-Schneider line that scores the goal to put the U.S. ahead. Here comes the second U.S. goal. A shot from the point. There's a lot of action around Netado. A few shots. Now, finally, he has to go down, and Strobel finds the top corner to put the U.S. ahead 2-0.
So 2-0, the United States on top.
At the goal, the third goal for the United States. It'll be a pass from Phil Verkota to Romanians in yellow, the Americans in blue.
Schneider, his second goal of the night. Here it is.
It's a very quick play off the faceoff, right back to Schneider, and he finds the lower corner.
Portal by Hutan. O'Callaghan. Kristoff, he scores! Steve Kristoff! Number 11, who was the leading goal scorer in the U.S.'s 61-game pre-Olympic schedule, had yet to score in the Olympics. Next one here.
Whose father played on the great American team at Squaw Valley in 1960, setting up Rob McClanahan, and watch the backhander. McClanahan moving in.
And Eric Strobel. Strobel in over the blue line. Strobel has his shot blocked out in front. The rebound goes in. Coaches brought at Minnesota. A 2-2 tie. Here it is again.
Well, Strobel makes the play again, going through most of the West German team. You see him swirling around, and finally the puck goes out to Broughton, ties the game. Here we have it again. Goaltender Schüttner almost is able to pick up the loose puck, but can't get that shot by Broughton.
Neil Broughton scoring. Again, you can't emphasize it enough. No one man.
The winner with the Montreal Canadiens as we take a look at McClanahan's goal.
McClanahan really does it all by himself, taking the puck at center ice, beating first Krul, and watch Kiesling here diving. McClanahan sweeping out in front of the net, putting the U.S. ahead 3-2.
That came at 1:17 of the third period. Brakota's goal came at 4:17 of the third period.
Fourth U.S. goal, shot by Davey Christian. You can see Verkota in front of the net, just tipping the puck underneath the glove of goaltender Schüttner.
So 4-2, the United States on top. This game only matters in a sense as to whether the U.S. finishes first or second in the division. And only matters further in the sense that the U.S. will play the Soviets on Friday instead of Sunday. Shortly we'll explain the medal round situation. The team's going in
the tournament thus far, outside of Pervukin, number 5, a defenseman. Pavlich taking it away for the U.S. Pavlich up ahead to Schneider. Shot goes in! Bud Schneider!
That's the type of goal you don't expect somebody like Tretiak to give up. And the United States ties the game at 14:03 in the period.
Well, once again, it's Pavlich and Schneider combining. A long shot from a fairly severe angle, catching Tretiak in the top glove side. He's well out. He's in good position, although he was moving a little bit in the opposite direction to where the shot went. Here we can see it again in the top corner. Tretiak has been struggling a bit of late. He let in 2 bad goals against Canada the other day, and there's some suspicion that he really is not in very good form at this point.
Bud Schneider, the only man for the Soviet Union. That made it 1-0. Long shot, the easy save by Tretiak, but Johnson is there and scores with 1 second to play in the period. Right now the clock shows nothing, but it was stopped at 1 when we looked up as the goal was scored. Right now it shows nothing as the period apparently has come to an end. But the other
rush on this power play opportunity. 13 seconds left in the penalty.
The shot again is followed by Johnson. They score!
A goal that absolutely came out of nowhere. The U.S. team did not seem to be threatening. The puck went to Starikov, the Soviet defenseman, who should have had very good control of it, but he lost it. There's Stilt. Now watch the puck go to Starikov. He's in good shape with it, but he loses it right under Johnson's stick and in the net. There we see it again. Stilt upended, but getting the puck to Starikov, the rebound to Johnson and in.
So the Americans, just as the penalty had expired, the Krutov score to tie the game. And finally, the building has come to life. 3-3. The United States and the Soviet Union with 11:21 remaining in the third period.
The U.S. team is depending a little bit too much now on Jim Craig. He's making too many good saves.
Arruzioni scores! Mike Arruzioni! Here it is again.
Here's Ruzioni using the defenseman as a screen. A good loose shot. Just the kind of goal that Ruzioni scored about 2 weeks ago against the Soviets in Madison Square Garden. There's Pavukin going down to try to block the shot. It goes underneath Mushkin's arm.
That goal coming at the 10-minute mark. Exactly halfway through. Up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game.
It's over.
You believe in miracles? Yes!
Unbelievable.
Ramsey ready to come out of the box. Here he comes. The team's at equal stake. And a goal! Kristoff scoring backhanded just as Ramsey came out of the penalty box to tie it.
The U.S. team obviously getting a big lift from killing that penalty. Got the puck in front. It was a weak shot, but it appeared to hit a Finnish defender's stick and went right through Valkonen's legs. Here we see it again, Silk going wide. He's being checked by the coachman. He can't do much with it, but you can just see it tip off the stick and through Valtonen's leg.
Steve Kristoff scores. We're tied 1. Steve Kristoff scoring from the University of Minnesota, drafted by the North Stars. Another look now.
Here he is again, going to his back, and it just tips very slightly off the Finnish defender's stick and is redirected right.
We've got the greatest news of all for you. As you can see, the Americans, the mob scene there, Phil Vrkota has just scored to tie the game. Phil Vrkota scoring his third goal in the Olympics at the 2:25 mark. Here's the play with Christian starting it.
Dave Christian makes a beautiful play. The defender's with him, passes to Vrkota who hits the far corner. Here we see it again. Watch the defenders all go on Christian. The corner is open. He gets Valkonen moving the wrong way. And it's a 2-2 game.
So the Americans, nothing has come easy for the last week and a half. The tie with Sweden in the last 27 seconds. The emotional game with Czechoslovakia. In fact, they trailed Norway. They trailed West Germany the other night against the Soviet Union. Now the game is tied again, 2-2. 17 and a half minutes to play. Craig stopping it back of the net. Ramsey. Up. Davey getting out in front. Backhands it, swept aside in front. Johnson.
And he scores! Checking, and Kristoff's shot went off the post.
Kristoff scrapping for it again. Gets it out in front, but the Americans control, keeping it in. Johnson skating in the shot. The reset, he scores!
Tied up, and there's the rebound goal.
Johnson, putting the U.S. ahead by two goals now. Just after it was Christoph and Broughton, while killing the penalty, forcing the play offensively. It was Ben Johnson forcing the play offensively. Scoring the goal.
There are about 10,000 people in this. The crowd going insane at the moment. Bedlam in here, stomping. To the gold medal, four to the gold medal. This impossible dream comes true. And so appropriately, that roaring chant we've heard for a week and a half.